Hey guys, and welcome to this video. I'm Pratik, a dentist and specialty doctor. And in this video, we're going to be looking at the dental core training application process during the COVID pandemic. It's really important to stress before going on through this video that because the pandemic is so fluid at the moment, some of these details could change and they're provisional details that have been released. What I'll be looking at is the basic steps that are in the application process as it currently stands with the COVID-19 pandemic. However, in order to stay up to date, remember to check the CopDent website, which I'll link in the description below. If you're unsure what dental core training is or whether it's for you, please remember to check out the other video I did on this topic relating to whether dental core training is truly worth it. But quickly, just to go through what dental core training is, it refers to up to 3 years of postgraduate training that you can do following your foundation year, and this is training that can be done in any specialty. So the application timeline has been released and this is it. Like I mentioned, we have to treat this very, very carefully and we have to take it with a pinch of salt. So like I said, in this video, we're going to be looking at the application process and the steps involved in the application process. So it's really important for you to stay up to date with things through the CopDent website and the latest application guide that will be uploaded on the CopDent website. When you're applying for dental core training, it's also important to check the person specification. This may not be as important this year because of the COVID-19 pandemic, but for future years, it's extremely important that you check the person specification. The person specification tells you kind of the requirements for DCT places and the desired characteristics. This year, there's expected to be a very, very high demand for dental core training posts. There are also some changes happening with the jobs that are available. Some deaneries are thinking of having multiple year jobs, for example, combining DCT 1 and DCT 2 years together. If we look at the dental core training application, it's typically divided into four broad parts. The four parts of the application process involve the online application form, the situational judgment test, an interview, and also preferencing of jobs. There is the application timeline that sets out when each of these windows open. There is a small possibility that one of the potential outcomes, if the pandemic gets worse, is that the interview process might be scrapped completely and we just rely upon situational judgment test. Now, the online application for dental core training is done via the Oriel platform. So you need to log onto the Oriel website and you can register on this even before applications open. You can fill in all your basic details again before applications open. This then means that when the application does open, it's much easier to fill in all the details, saving you a lot of time. It also means it's something that you can start working on even before the applications open up. Once the dental core training application actually opens, you'll see the post advertised. When you start filling an application form in for the job, there are various topics, various categories that are covered. This includes your employment history, your current qualifications. It also includes potentially preferencing the jobs early on. For those of you who don't know what job preferencing involves, for dental core training posts, similar to your foundation year, there will be certain jobs advertised throughout the country. Now, as dental core training is a national recruitment process, everyone is applying for the same interview and same application scheme. As a result, all the jobs are open for everyone, so you're not applying to a specific area of the country. So when you see all these jobs advertised, you then have to rank them on your order of preference. Ultimately, as I will explain towards the end of this video, depending on your rank from the situational judgment test and your interview test, you are then ranked against all the candidates. And depending on where you fall, you are then matched up to your job based on preferencing. For example, if your first and second jobs are fully subscribed, then you may be put into your third preference. And this is why it's important to preference your jobs and think about what the areas involve and what the jobs involve. Now let's move on to the situational judgment test. So your situational judgment test, or SJT, will be done on a separate day to your interview. And in the COVID-19 pandemic, this is likely to be done either at home or at a Pearson View Centre. So a Pearson View Centre is similar to those in the UK who do your driving theory, where you go to a centre, there's lots of computers, and you sit the exam there. Again, you will be invited to do your situational judgment test, so make sure you check your emails and you book in particular times. If you're doing your SJT at home, you need to make sure that the environment is suitable for the exam. Typically, you will be monitored whilst you're doing the test and you will be asked to show your surroundings. This is simply to ensure that there's no one else there helping you and you're not cheating in your exam. Another important thing, and you will be given some requirements for the test, is to make sure that your computer is compatible with the software. You're typically required to test the software beforehand, so this will give you a good opportunity to ensure things are working. But particularly at this time when it's difficult to get to other people's houses, to use other devices, make sure things are compatible well in advance so you're not caught off guard on the day. Now this year, the situational judgment test is expected to make up 33% of your overall mark, so a third of your mark. Historically, the SJTs have been made up of around 130 questions that need to be done in about 115 minutes. The SJTs are there to cover a range of topics. Unfortunately, they're not typically there to check your clinical knowledge. They're more to assess you as an individual and as a personality. The SJTs will be assessing things such as your appraisal and decision-making skills, your ability to cope under pressure, your critical thinking skills, professionalism, and also your ability to provide patient-centered care. So a lot of this are things not necessarily relating to direct clinical knowledge. SJTs are notoriously difficult to do well, and I will do a separate video on some hints and tips on doing SJTs. There are typically two types of questions. The first one is a ranking question, where you're given a STEM question, a scenario, and you're given five options, and you need to rank these from most appropriate to least appropriate. The other type of question is a choose the three most appropriate actions type of question. So again, in this, you're given a STEM question, and you're given several options. And from this, you have to choose the three most appropriate linked answers for the question. There are some really good books that can help you prepare for these exams. These books include the 250 SJT questions for foundation year entry, and also the Dental Foundation Training Guide, which has situational judgment tests in it. So these tests, these practice questions are going to be really important and set you up properly for the situational judgment test. Then we move on to the next step, which is the interview process. Now, during the COVID-19 pandemic, the interview process is likely to be carried out on Microsoft Teams, and it is going to most probably involve two stations. One will be a clinical scenario, and the other will be a clinical governance station. Both of these stations will count for another third of your mark. So you have a third from the SJT, a third from the clinical scenario, and a third from the clinical governance stations. Typically, you would have two examiners per station. Again, similar to the SJTs, make sure you're appropriate for an interview on Microsoft Teams. So you're dressed appropriately, you're presenting yourself appropriately, your surroundings are good as well. And again, you might be asked to show your surroundings to make sure there's no one else helping you for the interview. You're expected to receive the scenarios beforehand so that you can prepare a little bit. So the stations are likely to be around 7.5 minutes each. So in total, a 15 minute interview. When the interviews used to be done in person, one of the stations used to be a communication station. But instead of doing this as a separate station, your communication is going to be assessed through these two stations. So it's really important that despite the fact that the stations are clinical scenario and clinical governance, you still have good communication skills. So as good as you can get over an interview on a laptop. If we look briefly at the separate stations, the clinical governance station is checking aspects, for example, the seven pillars of clinical governance, and I will be doing a video going through these pillars. In this station, you can sometimes also be asked about ethical scenarios. So for example, inappropriate treatment and how you would manage this, safeguarding issues and how you'd manage them. You may also be asked to draw from your own experience, so it's helpful to have examples for a variety of clinical governance scenarios. The other station is the clinical scenario. So this is typically drawing from your actual clinical knowledge and expertise that you have in an area. So you will be presented with a clinical situation. This could be anything. For example, a patient attends A&E following an assault, a patient presents with significant periodontal disease, anything like that. And then you would typically be asked questions relating to the scenario from a clinician's perspective. A lot of these situations you can prepare for, but hopefully if you've got the scenario beforehand, you have some time to look at it and to formulate some answers. I will be covering interview stations in a bit more depth in another video, looking at some other scenarios you may get and basic tips and tricks regarding the interviews in order to maximize the score that you can get. Following your situational judgment test and the interview process, it is expected you will then be given a rank. The rank will be likely based on a scale situational judgment test score and a weighted interview score. This will then provide you with the rank number, and based upon how you rank nationally, you will then be matched up to a job. So like I mentioned at the top of the video, you have the option to re-preference your jobs. Looking at the timeline for the DCT recruitment this year, it is likely that the job preferencing window is going to be open for around a month. So it's important that you take this time to look at the jobs that are available and preference them accordingly. So make sure you go onto the CopDent website. All the post descriptions are listed there. You can get details on the specialty involved, you can get details on the likelihood of what the rota will be like, and other aspects of the job commitment. This will then give you lots of information to make sure you make the right decision when you're preferencing your option. The good thing with having a month to do this is you can go back and you can change things around until you're happy with the order of jobs that are there. And like I said, even after offers go out, even if you don't get the job that you may necessarily have wanted, there is likely the option to upgrade. So hanging on tight, seeing if other people decline jobs or drop out of the application process and your job may be bumped up. So to summarize, summarize, we've got the four main parts of the application process. We have the application form itself, we have the situational judgment test, we have the interviews, and we have job preferencing. Each of these four parts are really important, so you need to make sure that you check the application timeline. I hope you found that little guide useful. If you did like the video, please like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, it does help. And if you've got any other suggestions, please let me know. All the helpful links for the resources that I have listed in this video are also in the description, so you can get hold of them. Please make sure to also check out my new book, Single Best Answer Questions for Dentistry, which is available on the Wiley website with a 20% discount using the code VBT65. Again, the link is in the description, so you can purchase this book from any other major bookstore or retail website. Now, my recommendation in this video is the Dentinal Tubules platform and website. Dentinal Tubules isn't just about doing CPD. The whole platform takes learning and education to the next level through the options of an intelligent PDP, study club, and also the Congress that they have. I hope you found this video useful again, and if you are applying to dental core training, good luck with the application process. If you do want any help, advice, or any hints and tips, then please message me on one of the social media handles or leave a comment below. Take care.